ॐ भूर्भुवस्व तस्य पितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिवाइन गुरु एंड मदर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे स्पेशल क्लासेस। लेट अस कंटिन्यू अवर वर्क। In Tibet, there is a common mantra which religious people repeat, Om Man Padme Hum. He said, everything is hidden in this. There was a young man. He went to a spiritual guru and then he guided him that you should do it. But the young man said, don't be fooled. Everybody knows this mantra. It is not a secret. It is the most widely known mantra to the Tibetan. He said, it is true, it is widely known, but the key is not known to them for opening it. Do you know the key for opening it? The young man said, key? I have never heard that there is a key to open a mantra. He was having this idea within his brain that mantra itself is a powerful tool to evoke. That is the secret. The key is while you are repeating the mantra just for 5 minutes, just don't let any monkey pop into your head. He rushed down the stairs of the temple where the old saint lived. But strangely, even though he was not reciting the mantra, monkeys started coming, giggling. He would close his eyes and they would be there. He would run to this side and they would be there. They were not outside, they were inside his head, and slowly, slowly, the crowd was becoming bigger as far as he could see. Only monkeys and monkeys and doing all kinds of circus. He said, after observing this, my God, this is the key, I am finished. I have not even started the mantra. Finally, he said, let me take a good bath and get rid of all these monkeys. But the more he pushed them away, the more they jumped towards him. He took the bath, he burned incense, he sat in a religious lotus posture. But whatever he was doing, monkeys were watching from every side. He said, it is strange, monkeys have never visited this house. The whole night he tried, but he could not repeat this simple mantra. By the morning he was so tired, he said, the old saint, I will kill him. What kind of key? In the morning he rushed to the old saint and said, please take away your key, I am almost mad. The old man said, that's why I was not telling anybody, because the key is very difficult. Now do you understand why I was silent? He said, I don't want to listen to a single word from you. You just take this key back and let me go home. And I don't want these monkeys to follow me. The saint said, if you give back the key, never repeat the mantra again. The monkeys will come, I cannot help it. They are not in my power. The man dropped the mantra. He dropped the key. He descended the same step and there was no monkey at all. He closed his eyes and there was no monkey. He looked all around and there was no monkey. He said, it is strange. He tried just once on the way to see what happens when he says Om Mani Padme Hum and closes his eyes. And they were all coming from all directions. You cannot repress any thought. The very repressive process gives it energy, life, strength, and it weakens you because you become a defeated partner in the game. The easiest thing is not to force but to be just witness. If a monkey comes, let him come. Just say hello and he will go. But don't tell him to go. Just be a witness that monkey has come. Or 1,000 monkeys have come. What does it matter? It is none of your business. They may be going to some gathering, some religious festival. So let them go. It is none of your concern, and soon the crowd will disappear, seeing that the man is not interested. All your thoughts are in the same category. Never force any thought to go away, otherwise it will rebound with greater energy, and the energy is yours. You are on a self-defeating track. The more you throw it away, the more it will come back. Hence, the only way is to be thoughtless. Don't pay any attention, just remain silently, watching all kinds of things, monkeys and elephants, let them pass. Soon you will find an empty road, and when you find an empty road, you have found an empty mind. Naturally, everything outward and inward subsides, and there is a tremendous silence and easiness brings. Now body and mind, free from all motivation, always appear as void and absolute sameness. When you are in the state of no mind, which is equivalent to thoughtlessness, when there is no thought, cloud moving in your mind, you attain to the clarity of no mind. Mind is simply a combination of all thoughts, of all the cloud. Mind has no independent nature of its own. When all the thoughts are gone and the sky is clean and clear, you will see that everything that you have paid so much attention to you is nothing but emptiness. Your thoughts were all empty. They contain nothing. They were void. Whatever you thought they contained was your own energy. You have withdrawn your energy, just the empty self of the thought falls down. You have withdrawn your identity, and immediately the thought is no longer alive. It was your identity that was giving it life force. And strangely enough, you thought that your thoughts were very strong, and it was difficult to get rid of them. You were making them strong. You were cultivating them just by focusing them. You were getting into a fix. Suddenly, a man of no thought becomes so full of energy, energy which he had spread into the thoughts unnecessarily. He was weak because he was nourishing thought, which leads nowhere. They promise thoughts are politicians. They promise great things to come, but the moment they have power, they forget all their promises. This has been going on for centuries. Those promises are just seductive. Your thoughts are promising you many things. You can be this, you can be that. And they drive you, they give you motivation to become the greatest leader in the world. To become the richest man in the world, they drive you into ambitions. They become your masters. It is one of the various phenomena that the servants become master. And the master become just a servant. The moment you take your energy back, you become a tremendous force gathered in your own being and center. This is the first and the most important thing to understand. Never force anything, just let it go easily. If you ever want to find out what the secret of your life is, then you have to go inward. And thoughts are always going outward. Every thought takes you outward. When all thoughts cease, there is nothing, nowhere to go. You simply are at home. This at-homeness is meditation. Under utter silence and peace prevail. In this silence, every ambition seems to be stupid. The whole world of objects seem to be nothing but a dream, and your own being shines in its brightness of heaven. At the center of the vast expanse of phenomenal things and needing no polishing or cleaning, your own being is so pure, so unpolluted, not even a particle of dust has ever reached there, cannot reach. Only your consciousness can reach there, and consciousness arises in you with no mind. With no mind, you become so wakeful, so watchful, nowhere to go outside because all thoughts are gone. So you turn inwards and for the first time face your own original being. This is beyond all concept. What you are going to face in your meditation is beyond all concept. This is a very pregnant statement, beyond being and non-being. We are using the word being because you will not be able to understand while your thoughts are there that something beyond being and beyond non-being is in existence within you. But when thoughts are gone, the first encounter is with a being, an individual being bright and clean. And as you enter this being, you find yourself going beyond your individuality into the universal, which is beyond being and non-being. This is what ultimate enlightenment is. Leave your innumerable knowing and seeing and understanding and go to the greatness of Sphinx. When you come to that vastness, there is no speak of. Let us discuss about Buddha. Buddha himself had a great difficulty. Perhaps no man has had such a great difficulty in explaining his experience. In this country, the self, Atma, has been considered to be the ultimate experience. The two other religions of this country, Hinduism and Jainism, have both emphasized that to know yourself is all. There is nothing beyond it. Now, Buddha was going against all of India's tradition by saying that the self is only a door to no self. Don't stop at the door. It is a breeze to be passed. Don't make your house on the bridge, because a vaster universe is ready to welcome you if you can leave this small idea of yourself. What is this self that you carry, that all the tradition of this country and other countries think so much of? Hundreds of philosophers came to Gautam Buddha saying, what you are saying goes against the Veda, against the Upanishad. He said, what can I do? It is my own experience. I cannot deny it. The self has to be transcended. Only then you become one with the universe. The dewdrop has to disappear into the ocean. Why cling to the dewdrop? What are you gaining by it? All the religions say, liberate yourself from your attachment. Only Jain has the strange courage to say, liberate yourself from yourself. Liberating yourself from your attachment is child's play. The real, authentic seeker finally liberates himself not only from other things, but even from himself. He drops the very idea that I am. Existence is looked at from this viewpoint. It can be said that you are the center of all misery. And however you try, you will find you are only changing misery. From one misery to another misery. Maybe in the gap you feel a little light from one marriage to another marriage. Just in the meantime, while you have to wait, you feel good, but this goodness is not going to last. You are already feeling in the form of from another man. You are the problem. All other problems are just your children. A bus load of children and you are the driver. Buddhism particularly introduced the idea that it is not a question of dropping this greed, that anger, this passion, that possession. The question is of dropping yourself completely, disappearing into the universal energy from where we have arisen. Self is not the ultimate value. What are you going to do with the self when you find it? Just sitting stupidly, looking weird to everybody, just for a moment think, you have found yourself. Now what are you going to do? And remember, once you have found it, you cannot escape from it. It clings like German glue. It is not Indian glue. The self is only a stepping stone. Step beyond it, and going beyond it, you are just empty. But this empty is not nothingness. The word that Buddha used has been translated either as emptiness or nothingness. But in English, both words have negative connotation. Buddha word was sunyata. It is not negative phenomena. When you are simply available with no self, you don't have any boundaries anymore. Without boundaries, you can conform to anything. The emptiness of the sea allows waves to rise. That's all for today. I hope all of you understood. May God bless each one of you with knowledge of self, wisdom, peace, prosperity and happiness. Om Shanti.